firstly, the quantum of the scholarship is probably far greater than any of the other competing scholarships. That's one. And secondly, it's one of the very few scholarships which offers mentorship support for the candidates. So I think these two key factors sets this scholarship apart from the various other organizations which offer scholarships for postgraduate studies.
I share very similar beliefs with the foundation as far as the value of ethics in today's world is concerned. I believe that the foundation places a lot of effort on selecting its scholars and what kind of values they have and how the entire process of trust and sort of giving back to the community resonates with me deeply.
I think the Narottam Sheikh Saraiya Foundation's emphasis on values is something which connects with me on a deeper level. The fact that what they look for in scholars is not just how intelligent you are or how you think, but also about what really shapes you and what is your personality really is something which is very inspiring.
The qualities that I share with those of foundation are the fact that I really believe in giving back to the society. I really believe that I am very lucky to be born in an environment and a family that encourages intellectual independence and freedom, and I am a product of such an environment. To give back to such an environment and a society, especially like that of India, where there's a lot of scope in almost all fields, is a value that I really share with the organization.
So basically, the foundation and I share these wonderful qualities of hard work. The foundation had a very, very rigorous interview and application process. That psychometric test, that psychological test, and all of that was very, very difficult.
After I complete my postgrad at Berkeley, I wish to work for an operations consultancy for 2 or 3 years, after which I wish to come back to India and start my own logistics company.
After I finish my post-graduation, I plan to work for some time in some research and development organizations, and then I really want to get into academics and, you know, teach other children so that I can pass on my knowledge and experience.
In the long run, I want to work in the intersection of the fields of computer architecture and neuromorphic computing and develop some new technologies.
After I complete my postgrad, I plan to either pursue a job for industry experience or a PhD degree and help bring green infrastructure technology to India through industrial work or as an academic.
As of right now, I do believe that I want to come back to India and continue my practice in IP litigation in the Delhi High Court.
Post my graduate degree in law at Oxford, I intend to come back to Odisha preferably to start a legal practice at the courts. And in the longer term, I wish to enter politics and run for public office.
After completing my MBA, I aim to work in general management and healthcare, where I first hope to work in a medical devices company with the hope of developing low-cost devices which can help people access affordable and quality healthcare. After that, I will work in a general management role in a large diversified healthcare company and hope to build the same kind of healthcare ecosystem all across India.
Post my PhD, I intend to start a technology-based startup. This is one option which I've kept myself open to. The other is, of course, I love to teach. So I would always want to stay connected with academia and, you know, just serve the society in the best capacity I can. And I've identified healthcare and the environment as two large sectors where I want to work for.
I plan to work abroad for a few years to gain some experience and then come back to India and start up my own business providing software solutions for the chemical industry.
I aspire to become a field epidemiologist at the World Health Organization or the Doctors Without Borders, and I intend to start working in India in the National Center for Diseases Control. So field epidemiology is basically studying the outbreaks of diseases. So I aspire to study endemic diseases like dengue, malaria, and all that in India.
My advice for future aspirants would be that when you apply to the scholarship, just know that the scholarship is committed towards students who want to make an impact. So if you have the drive and passion to make an impact, definitely apply. And this is the right place to come to ask for guidance and help.
Never try to paint an image of someone that you are not and you're still painting it because you think your chances of scholarships are increasing. So just be honest with the application as well as the interview.
I think the first and foremost principle to keep in mind is just to work hard and to have a vision for where you're headed. The rest takes care of itself.